a real pleasure indeed. I mean that sincerely from the heart of my bottom. An audience with at the Butterwagon, there was a man standing there with a TV on his head. Something the man said, an audience were at the Butterwagon, and there was a man standing there with a TV on his head. Something the man said, an audience were at the Butterwagon, and there was a man standing there with a TV on his head. And suddenly the man said, an audience were testing, testing, 1, 2, 1, 2, oh yes. We're here to find out who killed Vaudeville, yes? Well, the elephant in the room, ladies and gentlemen, yes, is here, right now. Because you know what? I gave my wife an elephant for our room. She said, thank you. I said, don't mention it. But now, our message just a hand. Yes, we have the man who may have had something to do with the death of Vaudeville. Would you please make welcome on stage, the man who was showbiz in his blood. Yes, he was bitten by an actor. The fabulous Philias.
Occasionally resting with a schooner in me mitten. And on one of these occasions, when the bar was pretty full, the local blokes were arguing on a sordid kind of bull. And one of them there said, where you bloody been, you drongo? Haven't seen you for a week. And your mate was looking for you when he come in from the creek. He's looking round at Lyons and even up at Joe's and even up the Royal, where he bloody never goes. And the other bloke said, oh, I seen him, owed him half a bloody quid. Forgot to give it back to him, but now I bloody did. Could have used the thing me bloody self, been off the bloody booze, up a tumba bloody rumba shooting came to bloody bruise. Now everyone was listening, everybody heard the peculiar integration of this adjectival word. But no one was laughing, me, I wasn't game. So I just stood around and let them think I spoke the bloody same. And one of them was interested, asking what he'd got. How many came to bloody lose, he went and bloody shot, and the shooting bloke said, ah, things are crook, the drought's too bloody tough. Well, I got 40 bloody seven, that's good a bloody nut. So this polite rejoinder seemed to satisfy the mob. Everyone stopped listening and got on with the job, drinking beer, and arguing, talking to the heat, and bogging in the bitumen in the middle of the street. But as for me, I'm here to say that the interesting news is tumble bloody rubber shooting came to bloody lose. So, I thought I'd take a quick look at this tumba bloody rumba place. So, drove over there in the old ute. Man, it's a weird mob over there, let me tell you, a real weird mob. I was standing by the fruit shop on the corner, listening to this customer complain. And he said, why don't you show the fruit that we love so? That's why your business hasn't been the same. I don't want your peaches because they are full stones. I like bananas because they have no bones. Don't give me tomatoes or can't stand ice cream cones. I like bananas because they have no bones. No matter where I go, with Mary Lou or Anna, I want the world to know I must have my banana. Cabbages and onions hurt my singing tones. I like bananas because they have no bones. Billy Lee Dee Doo, Dee Doo Dee 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 Doo, Dee Doo Dee 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 Dee. What a dog, Billy Doo, Dee 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 Doo, what a thing. But I do all that where I go, with Mary Lou or Anna. I want the world to know I must have my banana. All the cabbages and onions heard my singing tones. I like bananas because they have no bones.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you later, Dunny Dunn. Thank you.